Last time on I, the Somnium Files.
Why is the screen shake so hard? Oh my goodness, I almost failed that.
Take this!
Hey guys, Raiden here, and welcome back to I, the Somnium Files. Man, last episode was a lot to take in. That last route ended so sad. It's really kind of sad because, like, on this side of the board, she doesn't survive, which really kind of sucks. By the way, I'm very curious. I don't know what this means, but on some of these it says begin investigation and then reopen investigation. What exactly does that mean? But anyways, we found out a lot. We found out about the prototype sync machine. We found out that it takes your left eye, or it takes removing your left eye or something like that. I can't quite tell. And we also figured out that, I guess because of this, it brings a whole new perspective. What happened to Date's eye? What happened to... Although now that I think about it, hold on. Which side is Date's eye removed from? I can't remember. That's still weird. I don't like that design for Date. Looks strange. Yeah, it is Date's left eye that is gone. So there's a very good chance Date wound up in this sync machine. There's a chance of that happening. And lastly, which you guys pointed out quite a bit, which I didn't know how I didn't catch on to. I gotta find out what this character's name is, because it's been a long time since she was mentioned. Shoko. Shoko's left eye was missing too, which means she was likely put inside the sync machine. But the thing is, what is Renju trying to accomplish? Because it seems like Renju is trying to get people to go to the sync machine. And a lot of people. I don't know why. I don't know if perhaps all these people were destined to die and that's why he's trying to get them to go to the machine. Like, perhaps he thinks something of the parallel worlds like we do, but then again, we don't even know if the parallel worlds are a thing. It's just an assumption that Date has. It's not something set in stone that we're like, oh, we know there is a parallel world. It's just, you know, everything's still kind of up in the air, honestly. As much as we figured out, there's a lot we haven't. I don't know if what Iris was talking about was real. I feel like I should doubt it at this point. I really feel like I should, but I just don't know yet. We don't know the boss's position in all of this. Like, in that one route, we figured out that she kind of betrayed us, but once again, that was just an assumption, but she's been acting too fishy. We don't know where Pewter's going to stand in this other timeline. Like, we just don't know anything. But anyways, here's to a bit more relaxing timeline, I hope. I wonder if everything that we saw about Iris is still going to happen to Iris, or if she's just going to be walking around, you know? Because we didn't see that thing happen in Mizuki Somnium where we saw her dead body, is she not going to die? Is that how this works? It's kind of hard to tell. I know that after Oda ran off, something must have happened to make Mizuki want to hide. So I don't know if these are like the same observations we're gonna have as we did in the other route, like if it's pointless to, like for example, if we look at this monitor, this monitor's turned off. Okay, I guess Aiba's not giving me the normal quip about the late, oh, there we go. CRT
Date,
monitor.
Look, it's a Braun tube.
Okay, no, these are completely different voice lines. A Braun tube?
Brown tube.
Oh, that's what she meant.
Braun. Ferdinand Braun, inventor of the cathode ray tube?
I can't get my head around that one.
Shh. CRT monitor. Some people are obsessed with these. Yeah, they're called Smash players. Or I should say Melee players. Alright. Pewter? About Somnium.
In a normal dream, the person experiencing the dream cannot remove themselves from it. Dreams are first-person experiences. However, the circumstances are slightly different during a sync. The syncer dives into the subject's mind and experiences their subconscious thoughts.
By the way,
this dream is experienced as an observer, as though you were watching a play.
Sorry if I'm going through stuff we already heard from Pewter. It is really hard to remember if we heard specific lines or if these are different or what.
The subject is the author, director, and actor. The syncer is merely the audience.
About that figure I saw.
No, that. I saw it too.
Who or what do you think it was?
Most likely someone Mizuki saw in person, projected into her subconscious.
The question I have about Pewter, though, is really the only thing that makes him go crazy like he did was Renju. So if we're not in Renju's way, or in a different case, if Renju's not even doing anything weird in this timeline or this route, is he still going to be on our side? Because I don't think he was working directly with the company that, or whatever big force was going after Iris, you know?
Dreams can only be constructed from images and experiences the subject was present for. Mizuki's Somnium couldn't have contained that figure if she didn't see it in person. Of course, not everything we see in our dreams looks exactly the same as it did in the real world. You saw some strange things in Somnium earlier, didn't you, Dante? That event you experienced is obviously not as it happened in reality.
I don't know, that's pretty much how Disney rides look to me.
Dreams are a collage of many memories, intertwining and blending with each other. Your skills as a synker allow you to untangle those dreams and solve mysteries no one else can.
Like, you guys remember when you get to the top of Splash Mountain, you just hear Goofy? Goofy talking, he's like, oh, time to die. I don't even know how to do a freaking Goofy voice. I haven't heard Goofy talk in forever. How does Iba appear in Somnium?
Iba is linked to your brain with an artificial nerve. To put it more simply, Iba is a part of your brain. During syncing, your consciousness is sent into the subject's Somnium. Part of Iba's self is also synced, but only a part. Not all of Iba's functions are transferred into Somnium.
So that's why Somnium Iba is so dumb.
Don't call me dumb.
What about Iba's appearance?
Hey, Pewter. When we were in Somnium earlier, Iba was in human form. She's never looked like that before.
That was Iba's idea.
What?
I thought you would be more pleased. I designed it to your taste.
What part of that was my taste?
I know everything inside your mind. You don't have to hide it.
Pewter, Iba's broken. She's talking crazy.
I am not broken.
Perhaps Iba admires the human form.
It's not that. It was just a little something. I consider Kaname Date to be my host. I owe him gratitude.
Okay.
I simply thought that appearance would make him happy.
Why would that make me happy?
Yeah, she said that vaguely a few times. She's like, oh yeah, Date, this is exactly what Date's into. And like, what part of it? The weird, like, shrimp hair? The stature? I don't know. Pewter's standing with his hands in his pockets. So far, if there's one thing I know about Date, you like skeletons and giant breasts, which I don't think you have either of those, Iba.
Pewter, who do you think the culprit is?
Well, let's see. Perhaps it was you, Special Agent Date.
Oh god, his face is so creepy right there.
What?
I'm kidding.
Pewter is standing with his hands in his pockets in his default Pokemon gym leader pose. What about you, boss? You know, I feel like, honestly, we've hardly communicated with the boss in the other route. Like, we went totally off doing our own thing 90% of the time. We went back and talked to her about things, but we never talked with her.
How would I know? We still don't have enough information.
Wait, what did I just ask you? Thoughts on the suspect.
Continue your investigation, Special Agent.
I also like these kinds of series because they're very easy for me to edit. They don't take very long. What about what I saw in Somnium?
No need to report specifics. We saw it all from here in the control room. What the Sinker sees in Somnium is projected here, remember? We've got it all recorded.
Isn't it incredible? I invented it.
He sounds so proud of himself.
Anyway, we know about the figure you saw. I wonder who that could be.
I don't know. There was obviously... I think it's someone who left the crime scene before Mizuki kind of hid in there.
Yeah, I'm glad she's talking again. You healed the wounds in her heart by syncing with her. Well, you meaning you and Aiba.
The boss has extraordinary perception. I deserve much of the credit for helping Mizuki recover her voice.
All you did was follow my instructions.
Date, Mizuki needs you. Protect her.
Do you have any questions?
Right, there was something. Hey, Mizuki. When we found you, you were holding the ice pick, right? Can you tell us why?
When I got there, the ice pick was... It was stuck in my mom's eye. I couldn't think straight. The only thing I could think was... I had to get it out.
So you panicked and pulled it out?
Yeah.
Okay, some of the facts are pretty consistent across here, but we could... I don't know, I feel like we could figure out some things. Like, a lot about Mizuki's story we just left in the dirt because of Iris and she was constantly in danger. But now that we don't realize Iris is in danger, or if she's actually not in danger, we can focus on Mizuki and get this side of the story.
And you held on to it when you hid in the column.
Yeah.
About the figure I saw.
Say, Mizuki, who was that figure I saw?
What?
Insomnium, in your dream. I saw a silhouette.
Date, Mizuki would not understand the question.
Yeah.
She does not experience Somnium as you do. You are witnessing a dream inside her brain.
How are you doing?
I told you, I'm fine.
You're not fine.
So annoying.
I annoyed you already, huh?
The pressure is annoying.
What pressure?
Force over area measured in pascals, dummy.
Why do you even know that?
I see she is back to her usual self.
Yeah.
Her attitude is within normal parameters.
I think I liked her better when she was silent.
About that figure I saw.
Never mind. Did you see anyone at the merry-go-round the night you found Shoko?
I did. I saw someone. In the corner, past the merry-go-round.
Who did you see?
I don't know. It was dark and raining. They looked scary, so I hid inside the merry-go-round. The door was open a little bit, so I snuck in.
So that's why you hid in there. In the other route, did she even say that? Are you hungry?
I'm fine now. But I didn't forget your promise.
A promise?
Unagi. You said you'd take me.
Oh, that's right.
So you heard that, huh?
Aphonia only affects speech. Her hearing should still be intact.
Sure, Mizuki. When we're all done here.
Seems kind of happy. So who sent you that Nile message?
I can't tell you.
Why not?
Because I don't want to.
That's not a reason. You were at the scene of the crime because of that Nile message. Whoever sent it to you is a prime suspect.
I don't think she is going to answer. When she is in a mood, it's impossible to get her to talk. That's the kind of girl she is.
Sometimes I think you know her better than I do.
How long do you think I've been observing her?
It's been 4 years now.
Correct. I know things that even...
Like?
That even you do not know?
Actually, never mind. Some things I'm better off not knowing.
By the way, we already looked into Mizuki's cell phone. Unfortunately, the contents were wiped.
I'm tracing the sender of the Nile message through other means, but it's taking me some time.
Do you have any questions?
Okay, just one more question. This is very important. When you pulled out the ice pick, was Shoko's eye still there?
I'm pretty sure it wasn't.
The eye socket was empty.
Yeah.
So the ice pick itself was just there to make it look like a normal murder, when in fact it's very likely she was hooked up to the sink machine.
Thank you, Mizuki. That was very helpful.
Meaning that whoever set this up only wants... They don't care so much about being found out, but they don't want people to know what they're doing.
Boss shines in moments like this. She doesn't hesitate to ask anything.
Now we know that Mizuki did not remove the victim's eye.
When we got to the scene, it was definitely missing.
And it has not yet been recovered. We can therefore conclude it has been removed from the scene.
Anyway, I get the story. Mizuki witnessed a suspicious person at the scene, but she didn't get a good look at them.
Maybe there's something at the scene we missed. Date, could you return to the scene of the crime? There might be more to Bloom Park than we first thought.
All right. Mizuki's lying in the chair. She's sitting, not lying. Seems to be doing okay, but she's got that gloomy look in her eyes. I sympathize with her. Last night she saw her mother. Well, she saw what no kid should ever have to see. It will take a while for her to get back to normal. Yeah, that is kind of the shitty thing about the Iris route, is like, Mizuki, you're supposed to be like one of the people she can depend on the most, and you kind of ignore her.
I'm gonna hit Date over the head with that.
What? It's just a table!
What? Where did that come from?
Many objects are scattered on the table. Isn't that a reference to, the Zeroscape trilogy? I don't know, I feel like I heard something in there about it, but I don't remember.
What's
locker.
Inside this?
Sometimes a cleaning lady is hiding inside.
That's disturbing.
A locker in the corner. The entrance. I don't know if we're gonna find anything different. Like, I don't know how long it's gonna take before these routes truly split into something different. Are we even going to meet Iris in this route? Like, she's not even relevant. When I returned to the scene, I brought Mizuki with me. I saw a suspicious figure in Somnium, but I couldn't be sure of its exact location. I brought Mizuki along to help pin it down. Oh wait, could that figure have been Oda? I don't remember. I don't remember what Oda did. It's been such a long time since I initially found out this information. I've been too busy tangling my brain with Iris and aliens.
Somewhere around here, right?
Yep.
So it was right here. In the past, there would have been a nice paved path here. It's covered in brush and weeds now, but I can still make out the trail heading back. The figure went this way. Do you remember anything?
Yeah, I do.
What do you remember?
I went to this amusement park when I was little. I was 4. I remember it so clearly. This is where I saw my mom and dad smile. I had so many happy memories here. The only happy memories I really have are from here. Memories of my family are so bright and colorful. But now, this is where mom...
Yeah, it sucks to have to bring her back here. And in the other timeline, we also, we realized that it wasn't as happy as she remembered. Like, her mom constantly yelled at her. So I don't know if perhaps she was a lot more nice before, or if she was that type of person that's like, I'm only going to be nice in front of Renju, you know? It's kind of hard to tell. Are you cold?
What do you care? You never cared about me, ever. And I liked it that way. I don't want you getting close to me. You think I like you now because I hugged you after the sink? Did you think, aw, how sweet, she likes me? Don't get it twisted. I only hugged you because you were standing right in front of me. Could have been anything. Could have been a pole or cactus. In fact, I wish it were a cactus. So stop worrying about me, okay?
So she says.
What's wrong?
Nothing. Just wondering where this goes.
Mizuki's looking behind the bush. Guess I should check it out. Okay.
Iba, what's past here?
This leads to the subway.
Subway?
It has, of course, closed down. It is no longer in service. This is due to the explosion at the chemical plant that occurred years ago. The surrounding district of Kawasaki was contaminated and declared off-limits. Bloom Park closed for the same reason, as did all commerce and industry in Kawasaki. This means the railroads and public transportation to and from this area were shut down as well.
Okay, can we
the
go there?
Subway. Iba, does the entire track run underground?
No. The track leading northward from Bloom Park eventually rises to ground level.
At a railroad crossing?
Correct.
Then the tracks must cross a surface street at some point.
Correct.
Railroad crossing. Railroad crossing.
Iba, do me a favor. Can you see if any cars were driving on that surface street last night?
Searching.
Hey, you've been quiet for a long time. Are you okay?
I'm talking to my eyeball, Mizuki. Just do something. Play with the horses. Mizuki's like, those horses are skewered and freaky. What am I even supposed? I don't know. Grab them, swing them around. You kids and your phones these days.
I'm just thinking.
I've got something. I picked up a single vehicle traversing that street last night. A black SUV. I ran the plate through the vehicle registration database to find the owner.
Who was it?
Shoko Nadami's ex-husband and Mizuki's father.
Oh.
Renju Okiura.
I cannot wait to talk to Renju in this goddamn game. Everything's like Renju was there. Renju was here too. Renju was here. Renju was also here.
You think that Daddy drove his car on the tracks through the tunnel, stopped at the closed down station, and carried Mom's body to the park?
I can't prove it was Renju. There's a chance someone else was driving the car.
Yeah. Yeah.
But, in any case, I know that the suspect must have used the subway tracks. That explains why there were no cars parked near the scene. Using that subway station, you could take the body right to the merry-go-round without being caught on camera.
Daddy didn't do it!
I am not so certain.
Either way, I have to talk to Renju, and you can help me find him.
She's so sure of her father. That's the thing, everyone's so sure in Renju, and they believe that Renju's going to do the right thing, but... As we learn from some of the flashback sequences, Renju wasn't always a bright and shiny person. He took part in murders for the mob, practically. So, I really don't know what to think of him, and he's capable of a lot more than people think. Center console. Steering wheel. Why don't we just charge Iba all the time? Like, it's so easy to do. It's like, every time I get in my car, I plug in my phone. Not a whole lot to click on here. Okay, Mizuki, when was the last time you saw your dad?
I think about a week ago, when I went to hang out at Lemniscate.
Did you notice anything different about him?
Nothing really. He was the same as usual.
And he didn't come to see you in the hospital, did he?
No.
Not even for his own daughter.
That is very unusual.
When was the last time you spoke with your dad?
I don't remember. It was a while ago. What about you?
What about me?
You try calling him.
I did. I called earlier, and I tried a few times last night.
And he didn't pick up?
No.
About the suspicious figure.
Hey, Mizuki, tell me again. The person you saw at the merry-go-round.
No, it wasn't Daddy. I know it wasn't.
You're sure?
Well, I don't know.
Oh, poor kid. You look like you want to say something.
I don't want to say anything. I don't want to talk to you. I don't want to talk to anyone who thinks my daddy is a killer.
Look, I don't want to believe it either. I've known him for more than 5 years now. He's like family to me.
I'd never want to put cuffs on him. I would never want Mizuki to see that. Anyway, Renju just isn't the kind of guy who would commit a crime like this. About the Nile message.
Mizuki. Renju sent you that Nile message, didn't he?
What?
I got this buddy of mine. Real bad personality, but real good with technology. Got some help from them.
Bad personality?
It was a message sent at 8:05 last night. Does it sound familiar? Mizuki, Daddy got caught up in something serious. Please come to Bloom Park's merry-go-round right away. Daddy needs your help. Please do as I say.
Yeah, that was it. It was from Daddy's phone. But I didn't want to say anything because that would make Daddy a suspect, so...
So you kept quiet?
Yeah. My dad's never said anything like that to me, ever. That he was counting on me? I had to go.
But you invited Ota along.
Bloom Park is in the middle of the Kawasaki district.
Oh wait, did we already meet Ota?
Hold on a second.
Yeah, that's right, didn't we? Yeah, okay, so let me clear up what we did before this. Case file. Okay, so we met her teacher, I think. Which, I don't know if we know if she's her teacher already. And we also... I don't remember exactly what we did, honestly. But we must have met Ota already, which I completely forgot about. Okay, we don't have to redo that entire introduction.
There are a number of homeless individuals in a high crime rate there. Mizuki must have been worried about going alone.
About the Nile message.
But it couldn't be him.
Why not?
Daddy couldn't have sent the message. Someone else must have used his phone. And his car. Daddy wasn't driving the car either. Somebody else did it. The killer did it, not Daddy.
The only evidence we have so far leads to one conclusion. The cell phone and the car were both operated by Renju Okiura.
Are we really gonna drag Mizuki into a subway tunnel?
Date, incoming call from the boss.
Connected.
Hey, I just got the report from Iva. Renju is a suspect?
He's definitely suspicious.
I agree. I think he's our number one suspect. He's been acting strange since last night. He didn't come see Mizuki in the hospital, won't pick up his phone, and he vanishes after questioning. He doesn't have an alibi for the time of the murder either.
He doesn't?
No, not one we can corroborate.
Any idea where Renju is? By the way, boss, isn't it a little harmful to pop up in my vision while I'm driving? I mean, look how much of the road she covers. This is gonna cause an accident. You're just waiting for an accident to happen. Any idea where Renju is?
I told you he vanished. Where are you headed?
Renju's house.
Don't bother. I had local cops search the place. They didn't find anything.
Where could he be?
We're not gonna go over the subway tunnels? I guess it's probably not that important since he just kind of drove through them, but whatever. Why did you release him?
So Renju was questioned at a local station?
That's right.
Then why didn't you keep him there?
Protocol. Nothing we could do. He wasn't a suspect then, and we had nothing to charge him with. We couldn't hold him.
Something about that tells me that the boss actually let him go. I don't know, because of how suspicious she was in the other route, I'm kind of believing that she let Renju go for some reason.
He didn't give us any new information. He didn't have much to say at all, really.
About Renju's alibi.
Shoko's time of death was estimated to be about 5 p.m. yesterday. Renju claims that he was at home alone at the time, but that means no one can back up his story.
I can see the boss through my left eye. Iba is streaming the image in real time. I don't have a cell phone, never cared for them. But Iba can connect to any network in range. And that's how I am able to communicate with HQ. To Mizuki, I look like I'm talking to a Bluetooth. She doesn't see what I see. Hang up the phone.
Alright, boss. Let me know if you find something.
You too. Keep me in the loop.
Where the hell did Renju go?
Sunpoke?
What?
Sunpoke. Or something.
Oh, Sunfish Pocket.
Oh, Sunfish Pocket. Renju was telling me about that place. It's a maid cafe that he runs.
I found it. Approximately 6.2 miles north-northeast in Akihabara.
I wonder if this one we're actually going to catch up to him in time, because in the other timeline, we got there too late, but this time we had Mizuki. The power of Mizuki compels you. By that, I mean she's going to break your kneecaps with a pipe.
can't be.
What? What the hell?
Renju!
What? Hold on a second. Hold on a second. So does that mean in the other timeline? When did he get into that car crash in the timeline, though? Because he didn't get into that car crash here. That wasn't until later. And there's no way he could have gotten into the car crash if he was already dead. So this is acting completely differently than the other one. Because in this one, Renju's already dead. But in the other one, we can't prove he's even alive because we never saw him. So is it a possibility in the other one, Renju was actually dead the whole time? But he couldn't fake being in the hospital. The nurse saw him. Oh, and poor Mizuki shouldn't have had to see that. And why is he...
You look awful. Have you been sleeping any?
My best friend was murdered, boss. I don't have it in me to sleep right now.
You seem troubled, Pewter. Oh, of course he would be troubled. Pewter would be crushed. Oh my god, I just thought about it.
Two murders, one right after the other. How could I not be?
Now this makes even more sense. It's super cool seeing the everything line up.
Renju had his left eyeball removed.
Right. Shoko too.
So perhaps, Mr. Date, you are the killer.
What?
You're missing your left eye.
That is such a bad coincidence.
So you steal them from others.
That doesn't make any... I guess if I were a sociopath, Pewter.
I'm kidding. Only a joke.
I'm too tired for your jokes right now, Pewter.
Actually, you lost your eye 6 years ago, correct?
Yes, but I don't remember anything from back then. I lost my eye and my memories.
I was transplanted into your empty eye socket a year later. We have been together for more than 5 years.
Ooh, let's have an anniversary. Why are you here anyways?
Am I not allowed to be here?
No, I didn't mean it like that.
I was here first. I was just talking to the boss about Renju's murder.
Also, one of the things that I found kind of cool is in the banner art contest thing, it's completely out of the game. But all the banner art submissions, almost all of them had Date and Aiba in it, which must mean that people are really loving this series. Once again, I can't thank you guys enough. I have never had a visual novel do this well. I've never had another series that isn't Fire Emblem do this well. So I'm glad you guys are getting hooked on this as I am. What happened to Mizuki?
She's sleeping at the hospital. They're going to give her counseling after she wakes up.
Yeah, she'll need that.
I see.
Her mother and her father. I hope she'll be okay.
About Renju.
You were the first on the scene, so you know this better than anyone, but Renju was murdered. No way this was a suicide.
Yeah. Oh my god. Like, what was this about? I don't know if he was hung up there dead already, or if this was some sick way to kill him or something. I don't know.
And the fact that his left eye was removed tells me that this was the same killer as Shoko.
The serial killer.
The new Cyclops Killer.
What?
That's the nickname that's been spreading around headquarters.
New?
Yes. Several years ago.
Pewter.
There is no point in hiding it from him. He would find out on his own eventually. It's all over the news. These murders have gone viral, so to speak. The killings from 6 years ago have continued. The Cyclops Killer is back.
6 years ago? Is that what you were talking about, boss?
Fine. I suppose you deserve to know.
This is something we never really learned about. Pewter looks surprisingly serious. He says Bondo is dead. About the incident 6 years ago.
We have a name for it down at HQ. The original Cyclops serial killings, to distinguish it from this new one. It was 6 years ago in October.
That looks like it was done by the freaking Zero Escape artist, actually.
Four bodies were found in the mountains of Akikawa Valley.
All female.
But the decomposition of the corpses were all at different stages. They were each killed sometime during May to September of that year.
But they did have two things in common. They were all young women, and...
Each corpse was missing their right eyeball, pulled out posthumously.
Wait, right eyeball? But everyone's missing their left here. What does that mean? How about you, getting any sleep?
Of course not. I've still got a mountain of work piled up. Answering to the higher-ups, the press. I'm just taking a little breather.
Cyclops?
A few days after the corpses were discovered, the killer sent a statement to the press. I killed them, and they are now my dear companions. Something like that.
They are now my dear companions. What does that mean? Does that mean perhaps he... What if... This is a weird thing, and I doubt it's gonna be true. But what if Aiba is actually an AI that is made out of a bunch of other people's somniums and a bunch of other people's subconsciousness, like, mixed into one? Or if they're creating something like Aiba and they're trying to feed it as much information as possible. But doing something like that would require someone as smart as Pewter. By the way, sorry if I'm slowing down, I keep slowing down kind of the story to theory craft, but you guys seem to enjoy when I do that, so.
He signed the statement under the name Cyclops. Hence the name, the Cyclops Killer.
The Cyclops is a mythological race of one-eyed giants. According to Greek myth, they are the children of Uranus, god of the sky, and Gaia, goddess of Earth. Cyclopes were known for their outstanding strength and smithing ability.
So the letter to the press wasn't a fake? It was the real killer?
Yes, it had to be.
A picture of one of the victims right after she was killed was sent along with the letter.
Was this Cyclops captured?
No. In 6 years, we never got a single trace.
Damn.
So maybe Cyclops is responsible for these murders as well.
No, that's impossible.
Why?
For one, the original Cyclops killer only killed women. Renju doesn't fit that profile. Second, all of the victims had their right eyes removed. But Shoko and Renju...
Okay, but... Damn, this also leads up to another question then. Because... In the other timeline, this person who was doing this was not acting alone. They hired an entire group of mercenaries, which doesn't make it sound like it's the same person.
We're missing their left eye.
The timing of the eye removal is also inconsistent. The original Cyclops killer removed the eyes after the victims were killed. But Shoko and Renju were both still alive.
But even so, you can't say for sure this isn't our guy. Maybe they're just doing things a little differently now. Or do you have another reason?
I'm sorry, Date. I can't say anymore.
Bullshit, you can't.
It's a national secret.
A national secret?
How can it be a national secret?
Date, please, forget about it. I told you already, you don't need to know anything about that case to investigate this one. The criminal for this case and the case 6 years ago are not the same.
Aiba, bring up all investigation records of the original Cyclops serial killing.
I already had a look through the database while you were talking. Unfortunately, I found no relevant information.
Damn it, they all know something.
I also did not discover anything of note on the internet. Only amateur theories, all lacking credibility and evidence.
Damn it.
Any other information?
That's all we have for now.
All right.
Special Agent Date, we need you to continue your work.
Right. I think I'll head back to where Renju was found, Sunfish Pocket.
Date, you're exhausted. Why don't you get some sleep before you continue your investigation?
I'm fine. Let's go, Aiba.
Oh, he is not fine.
Understood.
He is pulling an Apollo super hard right now.
Date, the vehicle is accelerating 2% slower than usual. Did you put anything in the trunk?
No.
What about the back seat?
Back seat?
Rearview mirror. Mizuki!
Mizuki!
Hey, watch out! Eyes forward, stupid!
What? How did you... Mizuki climbed up into the front seat, or the front, and sat in the passenger seat. What is she?
Hey, Date? Why do they call it a dashboard?
Because it makes the car go faster.
Uh-huh. And why do they call it a tachometer?
It measures how many tacos worth of revolutions the wheels spin. Because a tortilla is obviously.
A dashboard. The steering
Date,
wheel.
What would happen if I grabbed the wheel and spun it super hard?
We would spend the rest of our very short time together thinking about how stupid that was.
Steering wheel. The glove box.
Is this where you keep your weird stuff?
No, but don't look.
Damn, is it that obvious? That's where Iris is like, is this where you keep your stuff? Alright, I think that was it. Anyways, what are you doing
here? What are you
looking
at me for? Watch the road.
I always have my head like this when I drive.
You were looking forward before.
No, I was just projecting an illusion. This is the real me.
You project an illusion when you're by yourself? Your neck doesn't hurt doing that?
No pain, no gain.
What?
Adults have to make sacrifices. You'll understand when you're older.
I don't think I'll ever understand you.
Mizuki's sitting in the passenger seat. I've never actually gotten any dialogue out of the look option before. I should start doing that more often. How are you doing?
Well, I can still talk this time. Maybe I'm just getting used to it.
Mizuki's psychological wounds have been healed by the sink.
Nice weather we're having.
If you have nothing to talk about, you don't have to say anything.
Fair enough.
You're an adult. Shouldn't you know that already? If you start talking about the weather, it means you have nothing to say.
Damn. Brat.
What are you doing here?
I ditched the hospital. They're probably freaking out over there right now.
I'm taking you back.
No, don't! Nothing will change if I stay at the hospital all day. You're going to investigate, right? Take me with you! I can help!
How is a little runt like you gonna be any help?
I'm Renju's daughter. Maybe I'll notice something you don't. Something only his daughter would know.
I don't know.
My daddy was killed. I can't just stay at the hospital.
Fine. But don't say I never did anything for you.
You're going to take me along?
Just promise not to interfere with the investigation.
Got it.
Yeah, we got investigation buddy Mizuki. Do you want to catch the suspect?
No, it's more like I don't like sitting still and moping all day. I've grown out of my brooding pretentious teenager phase.
Odd thing for a preteen to say.
Are you not aware of Mizuki's mental prowess? She is far more developed than her classmates. She is even reading psychology papers by Alfred Adler.
Why?
Sounds pretentious to me.
I would agree, actually, Date. About Renju.
Hey, about Renju. Do you have anything to tell me? Anything at all that might help?
Well, it's not about Daddy, but I heard from Daddy that Mom had a secret.
Shoko had a secret?
What is it?
Did you know that Mom was the representative of an investment company?
Yeah, I did.
That whole company was a big scam.
A scam?
Well, I don't know the details. They start up a company to get people to invest in it, then shut it down on purpose and keep the money. She got really rich like that.
Shoko did this?
Oh yeah, we figured out about this in the other timeline.
Yep.
By herself?
No, dummy. Of course it was with other people. I saw gangsters there sometimes. If she ever got into trouble, she had them take care of it.
Scanning all known crime databases, but I cannot find any reports referencing this. They must have been extraordinarily careful.
Anyway, I'm glad that you're okay. How did you even get in here? Yeah, that's a good question.
It wasn't locked, I just opened the door. I've been here for like 10 minutes. Why don't your doors have auto locks? I know you like old cars, but you gotta lock the doors.
You should be a little more apologetic for someone who just got caught breaking into my car.
Hold on, I skipped a line of dialogue there.
I know you like old cars, but you gotta lock the doors.
Oh, I didn't skip anything, okay.
Mizuki does raise a valid point. If you are not more serious about security, you should consider replacing the car altogether.
You too?
So mean. Just want to have my car. So...
You were talking to yourself again. I heard you. It's creepy, you should cut that out.
I was talking to Ai about loud before I noticed Mizuki in the car. That must be what she's referring to.
Mizuki is still unaware I exist.
Why don't we just tell her?
Yeah, I know there's no reason to hide it, since she already knows about Abyss. It's just... hard to explain. I won't say anything yet.
Understood. But I am ready to be introduced at any time. Just let me know when the time is right.
It's not a proposal, no need to be so formal. Shit, I said that out loud.
Date, I think you should go to the hospital.
Okay, I talk to myself way too much. It's probably the side effect of doing, like, thousands of hours of videos, but I do this often. When I'm in stores, when I'm out doing something, and people stare at me like, who the hell are you talking to?
I'm not okay.
So, you want to go back to the hospital? I'd be more than happy to drop you off.
That's not what I meant. Why are you always so pushy, Date?
I'm not pushy, I'm just worried.
You've got a weird way of showing it. Doesn't look like you're worried. You're just weird.
You've always got something smart to say, huh? You're just like Renju.
Date!
What about Daddy?
Nothing.
You have no tact, do you? This is why you're single and always will be.
That's where you're wrong, kiddo. I look like a single father when you're around. Chicks love it.
Yeah, chicks love to see creepy old men hanging out with a sixth grader.
Hey, what are you implying?
Ooh, did I make you mad? Now I'm stuck in a car with an angry old creepy pervert.
I am not an old creepy pervert. And even if you were my age, you're not my type.
Ew, I don't want to know about your type.
Hey, you started it.
Stupid old man.
Punk ass kid.
Oh, these two are great for each other. They're like the perfect partners they need to get their mind off of everything. Should we really be going right back to Sunfish? Okay. Wait, hold on. Did I see that right? Was that just a menu?
Oh, Detective Date.
Oh, never mind.
Good to see you, sir. And this is...
Have you looked through the case file yet?
Oh, I am so sorry. She's the victim's...
Yes. Please, let us through.
So we get to investigate an actual crime scene this time. Again, cool. But hold on a second. Hold on, I skipped that. There are pictures of girls on display, probably the girls that are working here.
What are you staring at, creeper?
I agree.
I was actually looking at them, trying to see if they were the same girls that were in those photos of the girls that got murdered, but that wouldn't make any sense. The pictures of the maids on display. I mean, could they be? It's a little far, but some of them look kind of similar. Gordon Ramsay, you back there? I can see the kitchen back there. Nothing looks suspicious. No Gordon Ramsay this time. Doorway to the kitchen. The store's menu.
Dragon's Palace Pasta. 1,800 yen.
1,800?
Isn't that pretty average?
This is average?
Store's menu. A trident.
Is that a spear?
It more closely resembles a harpoon of sorts. I believe this is a trident.
Any chance this was used in the murder?
No. There are no traces of blood on the trident, and no indication that Renji was stabbed.
A trident doesn't look like it has anything to do with the case. A table. Can't find any clues on it. A chair. The oil drum must be some kind of interior decor.
The capacity of this oil drum is 200 liters. It weighs approximately 44 pounds when empty.
Let me check inside.
X-ray! Renju's watch! Oh, it's the watch that Pewter...
What?
There's something inside.
I stepped up to the drum.
This is the oil drum.
This is the kind of oil drum that has a lid.
Correct.
Let's open it.
Why would someone take off his watch? Why would they even bother with it?
This is the wristwatch Renju always wore. No doubt about it. But how did this get here?
Any leads?
No, we didn't find anything today.
What's your name?
What?
I was asking for your name.
My name is Kagami.
That was a suspicious answer.
The corpse was strung up near this counter.
The autopsy report indicates that the contents of the victim's intestines were excreted upon death. But no traces of that have been found in the area, nor on the corpse itself. This evidence makes it highly likely that Renju was killed somewhere else. It must have been considerably difficult to carry more than 150 pounds.
What do you mean?
Renju weighed approximately 158 pounds. I can estimate a person's weight by analyzing their bone structure, muscle, and fat.
What's your name?
It's Kagami!
What's your name?
Kagami?
What's your name?
I told you, it's Kagami! I told you my name like 5 times!
Don't get so mad! What's your name? I of course remembered his name. What's your name? His name is engraved in my mind. What's your name? His name is... What's your name?
Hey you, what's your name?
Seriously? It's Kagami. Stop bugging him, it's rude.
Excuse you? My best friend, Kagami and I are having a conversation.
Yeah, don't spoil our fun.
What?
That's right, I believe you could have done this at the first crime scene. You could have asked his name over and over again, and it's becoming like a running joke between the two. Are you getting enough rest?
No, not these past few days.
I thought so. Once this is over, get some rest, alright?
You too, Detective Date.
Alright, let's see. Counter!
Can you recall the time we discovered the corpse?
Of course.
Zoom! Oh god, that's not what I wanted to zoom on. Face.
The autopsy report discovered the presence of benzodiazepine. It is a common sedative. The dosage found in the victim's bloodstream was extremely high. It can be assumed that Renju's cognitive functions were heavily impaired before his death.
So sedatives were detected in Renju's body. He was barely conscious before he was killed. Damn. Left eye. Left eye's been pulled
this
out.
This bears similarity to Shoko's. The left eyeball was removed while the victim was still alive.
The right eye is still there.
The time of discovery was 10:20 p.m. You of course already know this, but you and Mizuki were the first to discover Renju's corpse. The body was hanged from the ceiling, similar to how a fish would be. A thick hook was embedded in the upper jaw, and the wires connecting to the hook were strung up on one of the ceiling beams. There was also a hook on the other end of each wire. The three beer kegs were attached to these hooks. We have found no fingerprints.
Is it supposed to represent something? Could it be that the person who's doing some of these murders was caught in the opposing end of some of their fishy business deals with Renju's wife, Shoko? And perhaps he's hung up on the ceiling because it's kind of trying to say they took the bait or something like that. Or like it was a phishing scam. It's kind of hard to tell. He was also choked. There are deep impressions left on his neck.
Correct. The face shows clear signs of congestion, along with petechia around the face and throat. Both are clear evidence of asphyxiation.
Any indication of the murder weapon?
Most likely a twisted piece of cloth. The culprit approached Renju from behind and wrapped the cloth around his neck, choking him in an attempt to suffocate him. The specific cause of death is cerebral circulation failure due to vessel closure in the neck. Put more simply, the suspect strangled Renju to death from behind.
Do we have an estimated TOD?
Yesterday, around 8 p.m.
So Renju was murdered about 2 hours before Mizuki and I found the body.
Renju's approximate time of death was yesterday, Saturday around 8 p.m. He was strangled by cloth or something similar from behind. Renju's corpse was found hanging from the ceiling beam, over the counter. Is that it? I think we're done. Beer keg. Renju's corpse was hung up by three wires. The wires tied to three kegs.
Each keg has a capacity of 20 liters. All three kegs were filled in approximately 55 pounds each.
You say approximately a lot, Iva. Three beer kegs on the floor. Each can hold 20 liters and weigh 55 pounds and filled with water. So that means, yeah, it was a little bit over Renju's total weight. What's the status?
Nothing special.
Okay, thanks. Cash register. Wood barrel. Barrel made of wood. Thanks, video game. Sign. Store signboard. It says Sunfish Pocket. Notice anything strange?
You were telling me earlier that you could spot things only a daughter would know.
I know what I said. I'll tell you if I notice anything.
You can leave if you need to.
I thought I already told you. Sitting around rotting away in the hospital would be worse.
Still.
I know what you're trying to say. For a little girl to find her dad like that and then want to go back to the scene, you think it's totally weird, right?
In fairness, it is also weird for an adult policeman to acquiesce such a request from a child.
But this is what I wanted. I didn't want to run away from it. I wanted to confront it. I didn't want to be weak.
Oh, I understand. She's so strong for her age. Mizuki's looking at the spot where we found Renju.
Are you doing okay?
Oh, sorry. Just staring.
If you're having a hard time, you can tell me.
I'm fine. It's not like the body is lying here.
Another inspector. Hope he finds some clues. The inspector's investigating something. Zoom on the counter! Oh, I know. That's not what I wanted to look at. Notice anything strange?
Did you hear me? I said I'll tell you if I see anything.
Notice anything strange?
Jeez, you're pushy. Pushy men are seen as desperate. This is why no one likes you. Besides, Date?
Hmm?
Never mind. Just do your investigation or whatever.
What was she gonna say?
Now is not the time to worry about such things.
Do you remember what you saw last night?
How could I forget? I'll never be able to get that image out of my head. Not until the day I die.
Are you really okay?
Yeah, I am. Don't you have an investigation to do? Or are you stalling?
Mizuki acts tough, but deep inside... yeah. This place is up on the second floor. There's nothing out the window. There's a surveillance camera.
Iva, Did you get anything from the surveillance camera?
Unfortunately, no. All of the recordings from local surveillance equipment have been erased.
What about backups?
There are none. Nothing was uploaded to the cloud either.
Damn. No footage of the incident. This club is located on the second floor of the building. We use the elevator to get here.
Iva, can you check the operation records of this elevator?
Searching. Found it. The elevator records are sent automatically to building management. According to the record from yesterday, from 6:30 p.m. until the body was found, this elevator stopped on the second floor only once, at 8:55 p.m. The weight of the car's cargo was approximately 310 pounds.
So I think we've checked everything we need to.
310 pounds. That would include Renju, likely another person around Renju's size. So it's about two people. I couldn't tell if they brought anything else. I don't know if they brought those kegs with them, but it's highly likely they found them here, this being a restaurant. Most of the things that they needed were already around as decor.
I agree. We should compile our evidence and inferences.
Mizuki, you ready to leave?
What? But we aren't done investigating.
What do you mean?
There are still people I want to talk to.
You want to talk to Oda?
Yeah. Oda is in here all the time. He might know something. I'll call him.
Ota's phone is broken. He dropped it in a puddle.
Sounds like Ota. He's so clumsy.
We'd have to talk to him in person.
He's probably at Lemniscator Matsushita Diner.
The only two places he hangs out. Do you want to talk to Iris?
Yeah. Daddy owned Lemniscate and Iris works for them. She used to work here too.
So she might know something.
I'll call her.
Mizuki tried calling Iris. By the way, I noticed this too, but I forgot to even say anything. The fact that Iris even showed up in Mizuki's Somnia means that... Well, I guess it means that she somehow knew Iris was going to be murdered. Or had seen Iris being murdered before. You know? And it was exact. She saw it the exact way it was supposed to go. So it either means Mizuki somehow has knowledge of what happens in both timelines, or somehow Iris was already killed and brought back before. Or maybe someone just described it to her, and then following that, she came up with her own image, which is scary accurate, but it's hard to say. Tried calling Iris, but there was no answer.
Have any idea where she might be?
I don't know. Iris is into a lot of things.
Any place you can think of that I don't know about?
Well, there is one place. Have you heard of Golden Yokocho in the entertainment district? Daddy used to go to a place called Marvel a lot. Maybe they know something about him.
Of course, Mama. Let's head out.
Lemniscate, Matsushita Diner, and Marvel. Let's head out.
Okay.
Alright, I'm actually going to end this episode here. We're at a good note to end this off at. Holy crap, this route is different. I still don't know if Renju was dead in the other timeline, but that seems almost impossible. We don't know anything about number 89. Is that his name? Number 89? Yeah. We don't know what he's doing right now, because he's not super relevant at the moment. We don't know about Iris's fate. There's so much we don't know, which is like... It's like it's an entirely new game. We can't scrap everything we know, but we have to compile what happened in the other one and what happened here and try to figure out which stayed the same. Anyways, I hope you guys are liking this series. If you are, please leave a like. It helps me out a lot. And if you want to be notified of when videos come out, please hit the subscribe button, because you can do that. And I don't usually say this either, but if you want to be notified all the time, press the bell icon and set it to all or whatever. I don't know, YouTube's dumb. I hate that they do this. They should realize that when you press the subscribe button, you obviously want to see videos, but they'd like to insult people's intelligence. Anyways, see you guys next time, right now.